when we celebrate Epiphany, people will think we are celebrating the wise men. It is not a celebration of the wise men. It is the revelation of Jesus himself, that the great light has shone in darkness. Those who live in darkness can now see the light. That's what we are celebrating, not about the wise men. We are not celebrating the wise men. It's all about Jesus Christ, who has revealed himself to those who live in Gentile districts. That is what we are celebrating today. So that the whole world can now say, we have witnessed Jesus Christ, the newborn King. How many were there, the wise men? Three. Are you sure? Are you very sure? Are you calculating? Look at your bulletin again, or whatever you use for today. Read that list and tell me how many there were. What did you see there? You are seeing three. Okay. What you saw there is what? The wise men. Yeah, I don't say all of my go school, pass me. This is one, Abby. This is singular. Are we correct? Singular now. If we enjoy, what will be? If we enjoy again, what will be? Does the addition of this one make it less than plural? Is still what? So let's assume that this guy is a man. He's a boy, never rich man. Never rich man. So he's a man. So I say one man. Abi?
Yes.
So when this one don't join, I will become what?
Two man.
Who wants to say two man again? So it will be two men. Now let us remove the one or two. This is a man, Abi?
Yes.
Man. He can become what?
Yes.
So remove the one or two. This one now, man, Abi?
Yes.
This one I'm waiting. You guys have a carry chalk come here. Who they talk men? Someone talk men even here. This is man, Abi.
Yes.
And this one I'm waiting. Men. And then if this one joined them, what they will still be?
Men.
Does the addition of this one to this place make it less men?
No.
It's not still men. You get the point? Don't you think it's possible that those who went to see Jesus are just, they didn't give you number then? So, can these two persons not bring three or four gifts? Can they not bring four, three or four gifts? They can. So, there are some errors I will just quickly correct. It's one of them I will read. Okay, this is the second one I'm correcting. The first one I told you, it is a celebration about Jesus Christ himself, who revealed himself to those in the Gentile district, that a great light has shone on those who live in the darkness. They're able to see it. That's the first one I'm telling you. So, don't think whenever we are talking about Epiphany, like it's about the wise men, not about the wise men. The second one I want us to quickly correct is that these wise men, they could be of any number. What we are most certain is that it is not one. It's more than one. But the number is not very certain. But according to tradition, it is this tradition that gave you number three. Are you following me now? The tradition that gave you three. And what would they give you three? One of the reasons why they would give three is that the most important gift, you see, I'm underlining, the most important gift they gave to Jesus were three. So we just make the usual calculation that it will be three. And the most important gift they gave to Jesus were, can I hear you say it now? Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. So these were the most important gifts they gave to Jesus. And if we say that they are three, what are the names of those three?
One is Jasper. One is Megaza. The other one is
Nephew. If we say they are three, so he becomes Gaspar. Can we say that now?
Gaspar.
But not going to use it. Gaspar. And then we call him Melchior. Now go.
Melchior.
Melchior. Melchior. Or Melchior. That's R. O R. Okay. That is Melchior. Okay. And then this one is Balthazar. So they are the three. So if we say traditionally they are three, they are this one. So I'm giving you this rundown. So you don't quickly say they are three. You know the reason why often we say they are what? They are three. Exactly to all of us now. We said that we give the gift to Jesus, we are what? Three, and that is gold, frankincense, and myrrh. There are two things I want you to note. When you number one, when you begin to make progress to meet Jesus, you will meet Herod. Can you hear me? You will meet Herod. Herod, first of all, will receive you well. Probably will give you gifts. It was not written there. I suspect that Herod must have given good hospitality to the wise men, treated them well. I told them, okay, go and search. So when you are making progress to be holy, you meet people who will make you feel so comfortable, but they're eating you deep. Let me give you a good example. If you know that rats has eaten your legs at night, don't be shy. Just wave it at them. Wave your hand now this way, don't be shy. Where is at home or your school? Where are you? Just wave your hand this way. Amen. Do you know what the rat does? The rat, first of all, makes you comfortable. You start being. It will blow your feet. Just to make you what? Comfortable. And so when you are comfortable, it will not begin to chop you. And when you feel the pain, you want to wake up. You say, calm down. Until the rat has finished enjoying what he's enjoying, you will leave. You wake up in the morning and begin to feel the pain. That's how Herod operates in your life. You make you feel uncomfortable. You are enjoying what you're doing, but just know it's eating you deep. But when the wise men left, it's not surprising to know they are also called wise men. When they left, they said, no, it is Jesus we shall, or God we shall listen to, and not to Herod. So when you are looking progress in life of holiness, just know that what matter is not people's word or advice. What matter a lot is what Jesus is telling you. Note that as number one. Number two is that there's nobody who has met Jesus that will go back to the same road. You follow another road. You remember that when they approached Jesus, what happened? They took another route. You cannot meet Jesus and remain the same. You must change your route. You must change your ways. So they change their ways. The same thing that we expected of you to change your ways. So if it was this way you were walking before and you met Herod, you say, no, I will not follow Herod, I will follow Jesus. Now, having encountered Jesus, you must change your road. They didn't go back to Herod. They didn't go back to Herod. They went through another way. That is the journey of all Christians. As you follow one way, but when you have seen Jesus, you don't continue on that path of perdition. Rather, you begin the path of salvation. We pray that God will bless all of you today through Christ our Lord. Amen.